Hello, I'm Lene Klein, and in this video we're going to draw hands. And hands maybe are the most difficult things to draw. And especially when you are a beginning artist, you can have a real hard time with drawing hands. But in this video, I have some special tricks and ways to make the study lively, nice, and good to do. It's very hard still, and we are going to draw in this video a lot of hands. Welcome again, and to study hands and to be able to draw them, you definitely have to make sure that you know how the mechanics work in a hand. If you cannot understand how a hand works, you will never be able to draw it. So what I've done here is I've taken some model hands, and then I'm trying to get the feel of how all the joints are going and how all the bones are situated in the hand, to be able to get knowledge of how the hand is working. There are many joints, and I really have to get to know how these are situated in the inside of the hand. Once you know where all the bones are, you can easily draw lines around them, and so a hand is created. When you are a real beginner at drawing hands, it's very useful to have these prints and to get started on thinking of the inside of the hand. So just determine where all the bones are, and the little joints, and all the little bones. Here you see me drawing the bones inside of the flat hand that's lying on his back. And what stands out is that the finger line is not straight, but it made an arch. So the index finger is a little bit shorter than the middle finger, and so on. You have to keep that in mind very well, so your hands look real and lively. Here the hand is kind of flat, and I still want to know where the knuckles are and where the little joints are. So I also set those in, and I simply follow all the four fingers, and I still can see the arch coming around here. The thumb could go anywhere. From the main joint, it can bend itself towards the hand or simply stretch out. Once you know that, you can easily make the thumb move up and down. I recommend you try this a lot. Once you have started with drawing in the bones, you can start out with trying to create a hand of your own. Now that we know where all the little bones are, we can easily take those lines and then build and draw a hand around them. I can see the knuckles. I can put in a little bit of shadow to make it more lively, and I can even draw a little finger, maybe that's just in the back, like the pinky you can see here, or how the nail is coming out of the thumb. And so you can start very easily and with smear lines to draw a hand. Here's my sketchbook. And as you can see, I've been studying hands a lot. And from the front or the back. And here you can see me drawing all kinds of lines to get understanding of how the hand is built up. And as you can notice, I'm drawing with a simple ballpoint. I do this because I do not want to erase anything. When I want to study something, I take a ballpoint and it's unerasable. And when I mess it up, I simply draw another hand. This way I learn a lot about the movement and about how everything, all the little pieces are going. And so do not erase, just simply draw. And when it goes wrong, just draw another hand. You can draw your own hands, of course, but it's smarter to draw from a different point of view. For instance, here I've been trying to draw a hand that's holding a stick. So, for example, I take the wrist bones, then the main lines of the hand, then I take out the line of the thumb, and I make the arches for the fingers. Now inside of the hand I can draw a stick, and now it looks like the hand is holding the stick, and I put in a little bit of shadow. You can do this in all kinds of directions. Maybe the fingers are a little bit more open, then you open them up a little and the pinky is just behind the hand. All those kinds of things. Here I've been drawing my own hand and my finger. And it's very important to notice that a finger has two sides. It has a top line and a side line. You can see it here very well. You can see all the wrinkles that the skin are making. And on the side, you can see the shadow. So that's what makes a finger rounded. So it's not a flat piece, but it's a really round stick-like. For instance, here I have a hand that's leaning on a table. Still, I can see the lines. Everywhere in my sketchbook, you can see the lines coming back. And maybe I make some folds, but I just keep trying to figure out how the mechanics work. And what I've done here is a very nice tip. I've taken pictures from myself and I made the hands disappear. You can do that in paint, you can erase the hands. And now I can start to draw hands on my model. So I'm being my own model here. And from what I've been studying, what we've just been seeing, I'm starting to draw out hands to put on this model. In this case, I'm standing with my hands in my waist, in my middle. And the thumbs are going around to my back, and my fingers are on my belly. Now I can really get the hands to go with my model. So it must look like it's... What is this again? It's my cat shampoo. Shampoo, go away. Where was I? Yes, the hand on the left here, the fingers are maybe a little bit more white or something. I can just decide whatever I want. can see me, make the fingers go in the three pieces. And you can see the index finger is shorter than the middle finger. And the pinky is even the shortest. Now I simply put in a little bit of shadow between the fingers so they appear open. And here's my middle and my waist. So it's not a beautiful picture I'm making here. I'm simply trying to figure out how and where the fingers will go, to make them go with the model. Let's take another one. This is a fake picture of myself again. I've completely erased the hands. And now I have to decide where the hands will be. So this is a very, very tricky study, but very useful. I do recommend you do this. Just make some pictures of yourself or somebody else and totally erase the hands, and then try to draw in the hands so it makes sense in comparison to your model. It's tricky, there's a lot of perspective in hands. You can see here, for instance, that the thumb is coming towards you. So you have a lot of perspective going on. So this is just simply a nice way to start drawing hands on your model. Now for the other hand, I have to decide again how this will go. Taken in the joint of the wrist, and now I can easily put on some fingers. Maybe one is going there. Just simply trying something and make it look like it should be. Maybe here I was trying to catch a ball or something. There's something else I want to share, and that is when you get the size of the head, you have to keep in mind that the hand is just slightly, when it's really open, it's just slightly smaller than the head itself. So here you see me drawing a hand, and here you see a head. You see that the hand is almost just as big as the head is. And you need this knowledge when you start drawing hands on your model. Otherwise, they would look too small or too big. So really, really keep this in mind. Here we have another fake model, and here I'm deciding from the bones of the arm where the hand would be. I'm keeping in mind that the hand is just about the size of the head, so now I can decide how big the hand is and what I want to make it do. Gonna make it simple, just a little bit pointy, and like the pinky is disappearing behind my hand, and put in a little bit of shadow. Now for the other hand, I should decide where my arm is going. I guess I want it to go a little bit straight down the body and then going up. And then I can decide by keeping in mind how big the head is, then I know how big the other hand should be. I have two fingers that are curved and two fingers that are straight, for instance. Well, that's a possibility. So I just try to draw that in and then I look, is that okay or not? If it's not, I simply throw it away. Let's have a look. It's about the right size. You decide. This is my last example from drawing from model. I want to do a boxing match, maybe. So now I'm going to draw in hands that are really folded, like a boxer would have them. What you mainly can see is the palm of your hand, and then the fingers are together. So you only can see the top of the fingers. Now I have to decide the other boxing hand. It's like I'm defending myself. Here we have the thumb that can be seen in this hand. On the other hand, it is not seen. And in the left hand of the boxer, you can just see the thumb. Put in a little bit of shadow underneath the fingers, and then you have a kind of a fist going on. It's rather tricky. I don't think this one is really great, but it's a nice start. Could do better, try again. Now, for the end, I want to show you that you can put away your pen now and then, and you simply can take out your pencil to decide where the larger shadows are. So here I've taken some photographs of hands again, and now I'm trying to decide where the main shadows are. So what picks up the most of the light, and what is the shadow side of the hand. This also gives you a great feel of how the hands are working. Also, how a thumb is building into the hand. That's always tricky. You can learn this rather easily by drawing in those main lines and those main shadows from drawing over pictures of hands. Now please do not be embarrassed to do this, because it's a very, very smart way to study. You can really get the feel of how the hands are built up and how their mechanics work. Here for the fist, that's always tricky. You can see how the fingers are going in, and how this makes it a ball, like a ball kind of shape. Also here. Here you see the perspective of the thumb coming towards you, and how the big shadows work between the fingers and around the knuckles. Here the hand, that's kind of a claw. The thumb isn't doing much in this case, but the hand itself needs a little bit of a curve. So here you can see what the bones are doing and how the perspective works. You can see now the greater line of the hand and what he's doing and the curve that it's making. Here, this is a perfect example of how the curves are working. The little joints, they all make those curvy-like lines, and then you can easily see what the shadow is doing in this case. It's like you are learning to look through the hand and to see all the bones. Here for the hand, you can look into the hand that is lying flat on the table, for instance. You can easily see the main lines and the big lines, the big fleshy parts of the inner side of the hand. And here, the beautiful example of how the lines work on the hand that you can see from top. And it's a way of looking and learning how to look at hands. Please do this and do try this. It's very, very learnsome. That's for today. I wish you all the luck with it. And I wish you draw many, many hands. And I wish you all the luck and take care. Bye-bye.